Hello everyone and welcome back to Minecraft. Today it's not a mod showcase. I want to show you guys this little thing that I built for the recent mod showcases that I've been doing. I didn't know what I wanted to do with this building. I sort of just started playing. I based it on a picture that I saw a long time ago on Reddit. I'll put a picture up on the video so you can see where my inspiration was. I was basically at this point just trying out stuff with the carpenter's blocks and it turned into this and I decided to use it as the base for the first few mod showcase videos. So how I made this, it's very, very simple. I use the carpenter's wedge slope, as you can see here, and I pop it down, and I use block of concrete, which is from Railcraft, I believe, and I place that down and then I right click it, and that's how I made all this really cool fancy stuff here. All I did was I kind of just offset things. Some of them are just full blocks here. If we just move that out, you can see that's a full block. There's a lot of styling going in there, but I just played around a lot and this is what I ended up with. Just to give you an idea of how I did some of the mod showcase videos, we have these portals. These are elevator blocks. They are from... they're from Open Blocks, I think? Hang on, let's just have a look here. I've got it along one of these. Is it Open Blocks? There we go, the elevator block. And what it means is when you have that block, if there's a block above it, if we knock that, you can see there's the next one. Oh, I just jumped through it. You can see, hang on, there we go, there's the elevator block for the next room. So if I just smash this open, you can see here, that was, that's old there. I have these blocks in here, so this was a little room that I had created. If we just knock this up here so we can go inside the room. What I did was I used this block here, this is the Lapis Salicis Caesius, I think this is from Extra Blocks. It's from one of these. I get so confused with these. Is it Extra Utilities? There we go, Extra Utilities. The reason I use this is because as soon as I press F1 and I get rid of the GUI, it is plain color, no matter where the block is. And it makes it absolutely perfect to edit with. It makes it the perfect portal room thing when you're editing. When you get into post, all you have to do is the second you get that blue, you can then cut to something completely different. Like coming out onto this area, for example. Did you see what I did there? All I did was I used that and I cut across. Very, very simple. Perhaps we should go back so I can show you the rest of this place. Okay. Right. Okay, here we are. We're back again. So that's all I did for the portal rooms. Again, we have the four portal rooms up here. These are doors, so these work slightly differently. But again, that's all I used them for. It was just a nice, solid color. Very useful for editing. Moving on. Some of you want to know what these lights are. They are, in fact, the blocks from the light blocks from Project Red. That's all they are. Because they have this border that goes outside of the block, it means that you can place them underneath things like this. And let me just grab that. And when you put them all back, they are leaking out of their square and you get this nice little rope light effect. Very sci-fi-y. I thought that was very cool. Most of the lighting in here is all just done by those inverted light gray lamps from Project Red. Okay, what else do we have here? We also have the lightning ball. He is made of custom NPCs. Let me just grab my wand here. There we go. Now, you may notice that I can't move forward. If I move up, I actually can move forward. I made sure that I added that in there so that I didn't have to keep doing, you know, stuff each time to get around here. But what I did is I used... Let me just grab... we're going to have to use glasses... pencil glasses. We can use the badass ones as well. But you can see that it was actually made with the pencil blocks from Open Blocks, which I did a video on very recently. And that was all I did. And to make sure that I was able to talk to the NPC, there's actually a gap here that I can talk through like that. There we go. Lightning ball, very simple. I could do a whole video on doing quests and dialogues and stuff like that for custom NPCs mod. But what I did was in here, we can see dialogues, we have pig. And if we just go to dialogue here, I'll set that into dialogues, pig. There's a dialogue text. That is the bit that's going to come right at the start there. And then we link it with a quest. So I'm going to link it with It Fell From The Sky. In there, we have our quests. Go into there. I've added It Fell From The Sky. Here's our quest. Completed text. Quest log text. I've got the reward there, which is some XP. I've got some item types. You can make it so that it gives you an item. In this case, I made sure that I had to give it a pork chop in order for it to work. And of course, the requests can also be... the rewards could be items and stuff as well. And we can make it repeatable as well. I use that for testing just to make sure. There are advanced things, setting up mail, next quest, all sorts of really cool things, console commands, whatnot. But I kept it very, very simple. And all you had to do is once the dialogue is linked up with the quest, you can just, let's just get rid of that so we can talk to him. Right click it, and there you can see there's our dialogue, and then the quest comes up. And if we jump out of, there we go, into there, you can see there is our quest. That's how I did that. Very, very simple indeed. Going along here, what else did we do? This was all part of the secret rooms mod. This is the secret chest. That is the secret gate. If I was to grab us here, the lever, we can see exactly like that, and it's going to power that, and that's what we've got along here. These are the secret rooms walls again, and these are the same blocks in white that I use for transitional effects and cool effects and everything else. That was for the last ever episode. Down here, we've got all of this. This is pretty much all there is to it. It was a very simple build, apart from, I guess it was a bit time consuming having all the all of this stuff, because you can't really copy the stuff too well with, let's just grab it. Let's go to wands and I'll show you what I mean. Wand like that. The Super Builder's Wand. I don't know what mob adds that. I think it's extra utilities, actually. Let me just go here and check, see if it is. It's, okay, it's not in there, but it is from some mod like that. I'll have to, I'm sure you can look it up. Oh yeah, it also says stuff. You may have noticed that at some point. You can set dialogue and everything else. If I go to Lightning Ball, what do we got here? Lines, world lines, the stuff that he would say randomly, buzz buzz, you know, nice little things. He just says that at random points. What are we doing? What are we looking at? Okay, the Builder's Wand. If we were to use these, you can see that they don't build as wand perfectly, because now they've linked up. They're actually turned into joining things. Very complicated. It's made it into a wedge slope corner block, which is really weird. So it was very hard to build because I couldn't use some of the cool functions that I would normally use to make things on a mass scale. It had to all be done by hand, as well as remembering every single one of these had to be placed and then textured again by hitting the block with it. So there was a lot of stuff to do here, a lot of expanding. This was all dug out, of course, using this one, the mining wand, which has disappeared. There he is. We go out here, very simple way, using this mining wand. I'm sure I'm going to do a video on this at some point. Right click, right click. There you go. I did that to make a massive, huge thing there. Let's just build that back up again. There we go. So that is essentially all there is to it. It was a very simple build. We've got the portals. Let's get rid of those. We've got... All right, I've damaged this place. I hadn't thought to back it up. I'll have to fix that in a second. I'm not sure if I'm really going to package this one up and upload it, because it's a pretty small build, but it is quite simple to make. It's very simple to make. I also use some micro blocks here as usual. I love using micro blocks just to make those little ledges as well. But there we go. That is a little tour of this world. I'm going to be doing many worlds for my mod showcase videos. I'm going to be planning a new one to build very shortly. I imagine the next few mod showcases will just be done without any sort of storyline and stuff while I get into sorting that all out. But there we go, guys. That is it for this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting, and subscribing. And yeah, that's it. Thank you very much, guys. And I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.